Pavlina Korkahai.
Pavlina Borgohain brings bronze to India. Pavlina, though, loses the semi-finals to world champion from Turkey.
A deafening roar reverberating through the Kokugikan Arena announced to the world that Indian boxing has a new queen. Indian boxing's matriarch, MC Mary Kom, may have lost her round of 16 bout at the Tokyo Olympics despite a valiant effort. But a new matriarch has emerged at Tokyo, and her name is Pavlina Borgohain. Welcome to Your Shot. You are tuned into our special series, India's GOAT, Greatest of All Times at Olympics. In this episode, Your Shot brings to you the story of India's latest boxing star.
मेरे लिए ये बहुत चैलेंज था कि मैं खुद को कैसे प्रूफ करूं। मैंने ये नहीं सोचा था कि मैं दूसरे को प्रूफ करके दिखाना है। मैं खुद को सोचा था कि मुझे खुद को प्रूफ करके दिखाना है कि मतलब यही मौका है।
Pavlina won bronze despite losing to top seed and reigning world champion Busena Surmenali of Turkey in the semi-final of the women's 69kg welterweight category. Under the rules of Olympic boxing, both the losing semi-finalists are awarded bronze. Pavlina's medal made it third at the ongoing Olympics for India. And strikingly, as in the previous Olympics in Rio de Janeiro, India's medalists have all been women. Earlier in these games, Mirabai Chanu, Pavlina's fellow athlete from India's sports crazy Northeast, had won silver in weightlifting, while badminton queen PV Sindhu added a bronze to her Rio silver. The 23-year-old Pavlina from Assam's Golaghat district not only beat but bossed her opponent, former world champion Chen Nin Chin of Chinese Taipei, in the quarterfinal. Pavlina had always found Nin Chin a tough nut to crack. Pavlina had beaten a German veteran in the previous round. With that win, Olympic debutante Pavlina had confirmed a medal for India from the ongoing games. Two of the three medals in Tokyo have now come from power sports, showcasing the strength of the Indian women and considerably raising the respect for a region and its inhabitants who for long have been neglected and even ridiculed by the cross sections of the Indian mainland, who have even blamed their compatriots from the Northeast for the spread of the coronavirus because of the similarity to the Chinese in their looks. As in well known, China is the coronavirus epicenter. Pavlina has become the third Indian overall and the second Indian woman to win an Olympic medal in boxing. Vijendra Singh and Mary Kom had won bronze medals in 2008 and 2012 respectively. We had been waiting for this medal. Everyone had worked so hard. I'm very happy for her, said Mary Kom after Pavlina's quarterfinal win. What a fabulous fight. Her tactics were brilliant. She used her right hand so effectively. Reminded me of my own days in the amateur circuit. God bless her. The 35-year-old legend added, perhaps conscious and even quietly happy that she has finally found an able successor. However, like most achievers, Pavlina's path to the peak has been full of thorns. She was born to a small-scale businessman father and a housewife mother. Her family was not financially well off, and her father, Taiken Borgohain, found it tough to support her dreams, but still managed to devote a portion from his meager monthly earning of 2,000 to 3,000 rupees for Pavlina's training, according to a DNA report. My father has sacrificed a lot. He has not thought about himself. He just wanted his daughters to come up, Pavlina said. Her mother taught her and her sisters to be strong. Indeed, Mamoni Borgohain's influence on the lives of her children has been phenomenal. Her kidneys started to malfunction, funds became difficult to manage, but she never let her children suffer. She always protected them from the hardship, taking its full glare on herself. Her husband supported her throughout, And together, they ensured that Lovlina's boxing dreams stayed intact. Lovlina's journey from a modest life in Assam's Barumukhya village to the fame and glamour of an Olympic podium finish in Tokyo is nothing short of a fairy tale. Lovlina had a wide interest in sports during her school days and used to participate in everything, her mother said in an interview with India Today. Lovlina and her two elder sisters, Licha and Lima, were initially drawn towards a form of kickboxing called Muay Thai. Her siblings went on to compete at the national level in kickboxing. However, Lovlina was soon to take up boxing and a future Olympic star was born thanks to her family and boxing goat, Muhammad Ali. One day, Lovlina's father brought sweets wrapped in a newspaper. Lovlina took the newspaper and started reading it. It contained a story on Ali. Lovlina was inspired by the 1960 Olympic gold medalist and former world heavyweight champion and decided to embrace boxing. The Assamese pugilist also admires the fearsome Mike Tyson. I like Tyson's style of boxing. I like Ali as he is tall and I'm also tall. That said, you cannot become a perfect boxer by following anyone. Everyone's game is different. I watch videos of professional boxers and pick up points from them and apply in my game which I feel is necessary, she observed. Her parents and sisters encouraged her to make a name in boxing. They told me to make a career in boxing. I'm here for my parents, Lovlina said. The 5 feet 8 inches tall Lovlina's was made fun of in school due to her height, her father revealed. But today, it is her height that is one of her biggest strengths. It has helped her in securing an Olympic medal, which is what every athlete anywhere in the world dreams of. The Sports Authority of India adopted Lovlina when she was in class 9 and she received vital guidance. Lovlina was spotted by renowned boxing coach Padum Boro at the SAI trials held at Lovlina's school, the Barpathar Girls High School. The experienced Boro immediately knew that he had unearthed a diamond. Boro took Lovlina under his wing and Lovlina's training began in 2012. Chief women's coach Shiv Singh has been with Lovlina since her sub-junior days. Lovlina's biggest break was her selection for the Commonwealth Games in 2018. A welterweight gold in the India Open cemented her place in India's Commonwealth Games contingent. However, controversially, she received the good news only after a phone call from the media outlet Northeast Now. She had not got any official intimation about her selection by then. At the Commonwealth Games, Lovlina narrowly lost in the quarterfinal to the eventual champion Sandy Ryan, but surely made her presence felt. It was such a close contest that, according to me, I had won. But in a 3-2 decision, you don't know who has won and who has lost, she noted. Lovlina's Commonwealth Games selection came on the back of a string of standout performances. The India Open gold has already been mentioned. She also won bronze medals at the Asians Championships and President's Cup. Lovlina's biggest success before the Olympic medal victory had been her 2 back-to-back World Championship bronze medals in 2018 and 2019. She added another Asian Championship bronze this year to the one she won in 2017. Her mental fortitude was for all to see when she competed in and won the quarterfinal bout of a tournament in Kaspisk, Russia in 2019, despite receiving the news of her grandfather's demise. Lovlina won gold at the tournament, and her grandfather would surely have blessed her from high above. Lovlina's mother underwent a kidney transplant last year. Lovlina visited her hometown in Assam to see her ailing mother. She was like a rock to the family and was so worried about her mother that she stayed awake all night, said Lovlina's father, his eyes welling up with tears. Lovlina ended up testing positive for COVID-19. That was nothing less than a disaster for her. She was slated to leave with an Olympic qualified group for a 52-day training come competition trip to Europe. That trip was crucial since the pandemic had caused a widespread shutdown of facilities and boxers were denied sparring opportunities even after camps reopened. Lack of match practice in physical and mental conditioning, especially in the Olympic year, would have been a killer blow to an athlete's chances at the showpiece event. And here was one of Indian boxing's biggest prospects struggling with COVID and having to sit idle at home wondering about what could have been. The government did its bit to help Lovlina after she recovered and arranged for a personalized training camp for her. However, it was tough for Lovlina to prepare away from her teammates, and the lack of match fitness showed when she lost her very first bout at the Asian Championships. To come back from that adversity and win a medal for India at the Olympics is no mean feat. Another strange problem that Lovlina has had to deal with is the lack of competition in her welterweight category in the country, and she has had to make do with sparring partners from other weight categories. Like many elite athletes, Lovlina has seen her confidence wavering, especially after the Commonwealth Games exit in 2018. However, she has not been averse to talk about it. She revealed that meditation has helped her in staying focused. She also realized that physical prowess was not all that mattered. She acknowledged that in big tournaments where athletes have to go through a lot of stress, psychological strength is very important. I had prepared very well, be it technique or fitness, going into that event. And when I lost, it was mentally draining for me. She admitted in a chat with Olympic Channel, I took to meditation to improve my psyche, and it also helped me strategize in between bouts. I started performing better after that, she added. Neen Chin victory, over whom sealed an Olympic medal for Lovlina, had beaten the Indian comprehensively in the World and Asian Championships. Lovlina tended to have a mental block whenever she faced the boxer from Chinese Taipei. The problem with me is I'm losing to the same opponent every time, Chen Neen Chin. I have a problem only with her, not with other boxers, Lovlina had admitted. I also know that I can win against her. I'm working on the psychology aspect of it. I have to change my mental approach when facing Neen Chin and go with a different mindset. It is not that I cannot win against her. I'm working at it, she added. Her victory in Tokyo was sweet revenge. Is ladki se char baar haar chuki hun. All I wanted to do was prove a point to myself by being fearless against her. I was just looking for revenge, she was quoted as saying by PTI. She seemed to have the talent and physique to make a good boxer. We merely guided her through. What stood out about her was her calm mind even at that time. She's not the sort who gets easily ruffled. Tension nahi leti hai. Boro, Lovlina's first guru, recalled. Lovlina's scripting history has come as a Sanjeevani for her mother. My wife got a second life, and now Lovlina's medal will only help her recover faster than we expected, Lovlina's father told India Today. Lovlina fought for her mother. She fought for her father. She fought for her motherland. And her victory has come as a balm not only for her mother, but also for her extended family that is known as India, especially during these dark days of the pandemic. This was the story of the country's latest boxing star, Lovlina. Stay tuned to Earshot for more such stories of Indian and world champions at www.earshot.in. You can now download Earshot app on Android and iOS. Keep listening. Thank you.
Earshot. Here and now.